I was actually working at the White House on 9/11 at the National Security Council. I remember that morning we were going over for the normal staff briefing in the Situation Room when somebody on my staff said that the first plane had crashed into the World Trade Center, which we thought was an accident. It was actually during the staff meeting with National Security Advisor Condoleezza Rice that the second plane hit. And she then went off, and we went back to the office, but were quickly evacuated by the Secret Service, which told us to leave the building and actually to run out of the building. I think 9/11 totally transformed the Bush administration, and you might say it even transformed the Middle East, because the president tried to figure out after that, what is this? What's going on here? What has produced this hatred and violence coming out of the Middle East and produced, in a sense, radical Islam in the region? The conclusion he reached was that it was the absence of freedom and opportunity. And it is from there that he went to the freedom agenda, the idea that bringing democracy and good governance to the Middle East was going to be critical in fighting the sources of Islamic terrorism. It also meant, of course, that foreign policy was the center of the Bush administration, foreign policy, national security, national defense, which certainly was not what it looked like when he was sworn in on January 20th, 2001. I think when you look at it now, 10 years later, we think about the freedom agenda and we see the Arab Spring. The beginnings of this thinking about freedom, the beginnings of the end for the many dictatorial regimes in the region certainly don't go back exactly to 9/11, but I think you can really trace a process that is connected to 9/11 that does lead you to the view on the part of so many in the Arab world that the regimes that had been in place there for decades were intolerable, and that freedom, which had hit the Soviet Empire, Latin America, Asia, was now also going to be the main subject in the Middle East as well.